string variables x, y, z are declared. Also, integer variables I, N, M, max1, max2 are declared. Max1 value is initially taken as 0. The printf statement asks the user to enter number of students. Whatever user enters, the same will be stored in the variable N. This program is exactly same as the previous program with the following exception. We are not reading the student marks. We are reading only the names. Only we are considering his name length as the marks. The rest, everything is same. Let us try to simulate this program. Let we assume that the user has entered number of students as 5. Thus, n value becomes 5.
I value is initialized to 0.
The for condition is tested now. I, is it less than n? 0, less than 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once. Let us assume that the user has entered the student name as Ram. Thus, x value becomes Ram. M is equal to strlen of x is executed. Thus, m value becomes 3. Remember, here m value is length of the string. I, is it equal to 0? Yes. Thus, whatever available in the string variable x, that will be copied into y. Thus, y value becomes Ram. Also, m value will be assigned to max1. Max1 becomes 3.
I value will be incremented by 1.
Now, for condition is tested. I, is it less than n? 1, less than 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once more. We assume that the user has entered the string Ravindra. Thus, x value becomes Ravindra. M is equal to strlen of x is calculated. Thus, m value becomes 8. Is I equal to 0? No. Thus, the control comes to next if condition. Is m, that is the new student name length, greater than max 1? Yes. Thus, Ram will be stored in Z. Ravindra will be stored in Y. Max1 value will be assigned to max2, and then this new student name length 8 will be assigned to max1.
I value will be incremented by 1.
The for condition is now again tested. I, is it less than n? 2, is it less than 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once more. Let us assume that the user has entered the student name Abhi. Thus, x value becomes Abhi. M is equal to strlen of x is calculated. Thus, m value becomes 4, which is the length of the string Abhi. I, is it equal to 0? No. Is m greater than max 1? That is, the new string length is more than Ravindra? No. Is the new string length, is it greater than Ram? Yes. Does the new string Abhi will be stored in the variable Jad? And then its length, that is 4, will be assigned to max 2.
I value will be incremented by 1.
Again, for condition will be tested. I, is it less than n? That is 3. Is it less than 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once more. Let us assume that the user has entered the string high. Thus, x value becomes high. M is equal to strlen of x is calculated, thus M value becomes 2, that is the length of the string high. I, is it equal to 0? No. Is this new string length 2, is it greater than max 1, that is 8? No. Is this new string length, is it greater than max 2, that is 4? No. Thus, no action will be taking place.
I value will be incremented by 1.
Again, for condition will be tested. That is I, is it less than n? 4, less than 5? Yes. Thus, the loop is going to get executed once more. This time, we assume that the user has entered the string Ramya. Thus, x value becomes Ramya. M is equal to strlen of x is evaluated. Thus, M value becomes 5, which is the length of the string Ramya. Is I equal to 0? No. Is M greater than max 1? That is, new string length is greater than max 1? That is, more than Ravindra? No. Is the new string length 5? Is it more than max 2? Yes. Thus, the new string Ramya will be stored in Z, and M value, that is 5, will be assigned to max 2.
I value will be incremented by 1.
I, is it less than n? That is, for condition evaluated again. 5, less than 5? No. Thus, program control comes out of the for loop. Then, the strings y and z are printed along with their lengths. Max 1, max 2 are the ones which contains their lengths. Y is the string having largest length. Z is the string having the second largest length. They are printed with the help of the last printf statement.